realize now how lonely it would be if I didn't have your voices around me all the time. That's what makes a team. A loud, sometimes maddening team.
Yeah, great work, kids. I think. What is this thing?
That thing is no thing, officer. No, in fact, the Crystal Crawler is...
Colson McCready! McCready, but why?
Because he'd sunk all his money into the Crystal Canopy Tour Company, and you were trying to shut down the case for good. I started to get suspicious when we found the sabotage sonar equipment. It didn't make sense why a monster would want to ruin some science equipment, but it made even less sense why a scientist would. Whoever did it must have wanted to stop them from finishing their experiments. But the first clue that pointed to McCready was the powder on Scooby's back. We knew the print was left by the crawler, but none of us knew what it was. Until we saw how slippery the cave walls were. Everything came together when we remembered how Velma fell off those rocks. Only an experienced caver would be able to climb them, because Velma kept falling down.
Yes, we get it.
But like, McCready was the one who found the crystal canopy in the first place. He had plenty of experience climbing rocks.
Unlike Velma.
Can we move on, please?
And he knew that in order to keep your hands dry so you could grip the rocks, you used chalk powder. He was caught white-handed.
It works on one level.
And I would have gotten away with it, too, if it wasn't for you.
Meddling kids, right? Right?
Why, yes. How did you know? That's remarkable. It's not like meddling is the obvious word in that context. I mean, it's a bit archaic of an expression, but yes, meddling. That's exactly what I was going to say.
Okay. Now, I'm freaked out. Let's leave here. Now.
Hey, great job, kids.
Indeed. But who is this awful person who ruined my party?
Well, the real head that belongs to the Headless Count is... Radwick Haverall.
Radwick Haverall?
Steve!
That's right. Radwick used the Legend of the Headless Count as his real costume. He secretly read the Master Mystery Book, so he'd know where everyone was supposed to be and could control the game.
So that's how you were Master Sleuth all those years in a row. You cheated!
Radwick knew the mystery ended in the basement pantry, so that would be the last place everyone would go, except the kitchen maid, so he got rid of her.
To make sure he was the only Headless Count in the game, he also took Colander out, along with anyone else in his way.
But why, Radwick?
Simple. Money. Radwick must have blown through his fortune. He was robbing everyone's room while they were playing the game. The first clue was the empty jewelry boxes, but the real clue was the rented limousine keys he dropped while robbing Dame Bernice. Since Radwick couldn't afford a driver, he drove himself to hide the fact that he was having money problems.
I would have gotten away with it too if it weren't for you, my dear, sweet, meddling Daphne, and your vile friends.
Yeah, whatever, Kingy. Woulda, shoulda, coulda. Off with his head! Or jail works.
Now, let's see who is behind this mystery.
Jasper Krall!
That's right. Jasper Krall felt he created Bones Mold and started to believe he was really the star. Here's what the bad guys say when they play with a law forbids.
Would have gotten away with it too if it wasn't for you meddling kids.
You did it, kids! You caught the Yeti!
Appearances can be deceiving, Chaz. What we actually caught was...
Mr. Howard!
Jack Howard has lived above this restaurant space for decades, but he never wanted a kitchen under his apartment. That's why he scared away every restaurant that ever tried to open here. The noise kept him up at night. Gaining access from the floorboards of his apartment, he diverted the cold from the freezer to create the Yeti's chilling effect, which caused the power to go out during his attacks. He couldn't get in from the outside, so he used his cane to prop a window open.
Ooh, you kids are good at mystery solving, but there's still one thing I don't understand. Why a Yeti costume?
Well, Chaz, sometimes the answer is so simple it's just easily overlooked. According to my records, the first restaurant that shut down here served Tibetan food, which is why he chose the Yeti costume. And he's just been using it ever since.
You meddling kids got me, but at least this Yeti costume has more than paid for itself over the years.
Kids, thank you for stopping this thing, but I still don't understand what went wrong.
Not what went wrong, who went wrong.
Mallory O'Neill.
So it was Mallory the whole time, but how?
As Mann's assistant, Mallory had access to all of the company's products, including their technical manuals, allowing her the wireless access codes for everything at Manputer Tech. She used a remote transmitter receiver to upload a virus into the Butler 3000 through Cloy's laptop, which made it seem as if an artificial intelligence had taken control, when really it was her all along.
But why?
Because with an app like the Butler 3000 taking care of the small, everyday tasks, there'd be no need for personal assistance. Mallory would be out of a job.
That's absurd. Coffee! Oh, I get it.
That's why she sent all those emails warning you about the potential dangers of the Butler 3000 program. When you wouldn't listen, she had no choice but to show you the danger was real.
And I would have gotten away with it too, if not for you meddling human meat sacks. Wow. Sorry, it's hard to get out of character.